So we're gonna start episode one of Life is Strange today. Very excited about it. This is a story-based game. Kind of in the same realm as The Walking Dead or the Telltale games. It's a little bit more, I don't know, I guess centered in reality a little bit. There is some magical stuff. We'll get to it. I'm very excited to play through. And yeah, shout out to the Don't Nod team for their recent launch. I was just talking to some of them on Facebook, and they're very excited that that game is finally out. And there's Life is Strange, and then there's a sequel or a prequel to Life is Strange, and then I believe that Life is Strange 2 is coming out or going to be announced soon. But don't quote me on that. So let's get started. Start in one, I guess. Let's do options, settings, language, and subtitles. Subtitles, yes. Subtitle size, normal. Semi-opaque overlay. I guess we'll play for a little bit and then see if it's hard to read. Audio settings, master, sound effects. Always turn your sound effects down. They're the worst. Alright, new game. Let's do this. I'm gonna mute during cutscenes and shit. Choose wisely. Will it affect the past, present, and future? Oh shit. That's a good question.
I'm trapped in a storm? How did I get here? And where is here?
Alright, inner monologue, I like it.
There's the lighthouse. I'll be safe if I can make it there.
Get to the lighthouse.
Please let me make it there.
This is like the worst BioShock spin-off ever. Oh shit, that was a giant tornado. That was just a skull on that map. That was a skull? Skull means death. I know the storm's really loud, but how's the audio level? My voice versus the game.
Holy shit.
Levels are good. Oh my god. No, stop. I want to take screenshots, but... Oh no!
Whoa. That was so surreal.
What the fuck?
Little pieces of time. But he could be talking about photography, as he likely was.
Okay. I'm in class. Everything's cool.
Be cool.
I'm okay.
From light to shadow. From color to chiaroscuro. Now, can you give me an example of a photographer who perfectly captured the human condition in black and white?
I didn't fall asleep, and that Anybody? Sure didn't feel like a dream.
Bueller?
Weird.
Diane Bueller?
There you go, Victoria.
Look at this crap. How can I show this to Mr. Jefferson?
That's a nice photo.
The class laughing at me now.
Why Arbus?
Because of her images of hopeless faces. You feel like totally haunted by the eyes of those sad mothers and children.
She saw humanity as torture.
I can't believe,
right?
I still have this pencil case. Frankly, I should upgrade to the 21st century.
Keep that to yourself.
But I like it old school.
Seriously though, I could frame any one of you in a dark corner and capture you in a moment of desperation. And any one of you could do that to me. Isn't that too easy? Too obvious?
I haven't kept up with my journal as much as I should.
Nobody does. Don't worry about it.
She had a brilliant
I do love my analog camera. She could have taken I should take a quick picture now.
I have to admit, I'm not a big fan of her work.
Taking selfies.
I prefer Robert...
Shh. I believe Max has taken what you kids call a selfie. A dumb word for a wonderful photographic tradition. And Max has a gift. Of course, as you all know, the photo portrait has been popular since the early 1800s. Your generation was not the first to use images for selfie expression. Sorry, I couldn't resist. The point remains that the portraiture has always been a vital aspect of art and photography for as long as it's been around. Now, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits?
Oh, damn.
I did know, but I kind of forgot.
You either know this or not, Max. Is there anybody here who knows their stuff?
Louis Daguerre was a French painter who created daguerreotypes, a process that gave portraits a sharp reflective style like a mirror.
Oh, damn.
Now you're totally stuck in the retro zone. Sad face.
Very good, Victoria.
She just verbally used an emoji?
The process brought out fine detail in people's faces, making them extremely popular from the 1800s onward. The first American daguerreotype self-portrait was done by Robert...
If anybody else looked at this, what would they think?
I have to keep telling myself in all caps that I'm going to Blackwell Academy. I'm leaving Seattle to go back to Arcadia Bay. Just want things to be different at Blackwell. Blackwell sucks ass. Told myself not to whine so much, but damn! More to tell, but journal, forgive me, I'm truly wiped out. I have an ass load of homework, so much bullshit. I get suspended, but him and Victoria are part of this silly elite vortex club. The winner gets a trip to San Francisco. Nice. At least I'm trying to climb out of my cocoon. I shouldn't expect my life to completely change after a few weeks of Blackwell Academy. Alright, character profiles. Shush, I'm dreaming. Max. Teacher. That girl that got hit in the face with a paper ball. Oh shit, these are pictures I can take? Alright. Gotta keep our eye out for those things.
Cornelius. You can find out all about him in your textbook. Or even online. And guys, don't forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday Heroes contest. I'll fly out with the winner to San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the art world. It's great exposure, and it can kickstart a career in photography. So Stella and Alyssa, get it together. Taylor! Don't hide. I'm still waiting for your entry, too. And yes, Max, I see you pretending not to see me.
Lol. So is she a photography major, then?
Of course. Victoria has to have the bestest, newest, most I should have known. She'll have better equipment than Blackwell. Even her school books are gift-wrapped. I can't believe she made fun of me in class. What is she, 15 years old? Damn, they have carbon fiber tripods here. The ball head even has a pan lock? God, I'm such a photo nerd. That was amazing when Mr. Jefferson took a class picture the first week. Even though Mumbo I didn't jumbo. Want to be in the picture at all, it was fairly fucking cool to watch him at work framing us.
It's an alright picture, I guess. Pop
I love
fine.
Seeing Mr. Jefferson's awesome photos on these magazine covers.
School kid with a crush on her teacher?
That printer is amazing. I'd love to see how it reproduces my pictures. I could pump out a whole gallery show with that thing. Looks like somebody was already working on this. Cool.
Cool.
Hi, Kate.
Oh. Hi, Max.
Kate, I hope I didn't embarrass you with my lame answer.
It sucks to be dragged into the spotlight.
Unless you're Victoria.
She's got nothing on you, Max. Well, I should get going.
Yeah, me too. Talk to you later.
Sure.
Dope. Good conversation.
Now I wish I wouldn't have read this. Purge.
Well. Look out the window.
I like this panoramic view of Blackwell. Everything looks so green and serene.
Green and serene. Don't shake it. Oh, sweet. I got that photo. Rachel Amber forever. BFFs.
This is definitely where cameras go to heaven. Oh man, they have those sweet ultrasounds. So cool that we can check these out anytime. The Decisive Moment by Henri Cartier-Bresson. That's rare. Annie Leibovitz, mad respect.
The mad respect.
Smith, good to see Avedon among the masters.
It's real dope.
Of course. Here's the poster for the contest.
Are you an everyday hero?
Expects me to enter. Why? I don't know if I'm ready for my 15 minutes of infamy. Man, he even has the best plasma HDTV for a class monitor. Can't wait to watch some more documentaries on this bad boy. Even in pictures, the forest around here always looks mysterious.
Mysterious photos of forest. What did you miss? You didn't miss much, actually, Pro Gamer. We're just in the first little area here.
Escape the lighthouse here.
Ooh, ominous.
Whoa, Mr. Jefferson is not messing around with that monster. He probably paid 20 grand for that camera. I bet he gets pristine digital images. But I still dig my little instant camera. Excuse me, Mr. Jefferson, can I talk to you for a moment?
Yes, excuse you.
No, Victoria, excuse us. I'd never let one of photography's future stars avoid handing in her picture.
Do I have to?
I just don't think it's that big a deal.
Max, you're a better photographer than a liar. Now, I know it's a drag to hear some old dude lecture you, but life won't wait for you to play catch up. You're young, the world is yours, blah, 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 right? But you do have a gift. You have the fever to take images, to frame the world only the way you envision it. Now, all you need is the courage to share your gift with others.
Share it.
That's what separates the artist.
Share it so hard.
The amateur.
Every time I look at Victoria, I feel like she's talking smack about me.
Well, hello.
This is ridiculous. I always get so shy and nervous around Mr. Jefferson.
Okay, fine, I'm leaving.
You didn't tell me how cute I looked yet.
I was about to.
Welcome to the real world.
Oh boy.
Then I might send you a special picture.
I'm not paying $150 for it.
Because Max wants everybody to see how cute she is.
So many noises.
I need a serious timeout in the bathroom. Splash water on my face and make sure I don't look like a total loser.
I hate that.
Total loser. sweet pose.
She's so fucking shy. She takes selfies with a giant camera.
Squeenix, don't nod. Okay, I'll let you know if you're being too loud. Stop. I can't really hear anything anyway, that my headphones are pretty loud.
Evan doesn't say much to me, but his photos are very cool.
I assume she would.
Yes, this poster must stop bullies dead in their tracks. American girls, I'd like to. Having everybody see inside my locker. I love that picture of Mom and Dad. Hello, Jack. Kiss, kiss. Andy, you look totally fabulous, as usual.
Andy Warhol.
Stella is always deep in her notes. She didn't come to Blackwell to mess around.
Justin.
That's Dana talking to. I think his name is Justin. American girls in the movies. No, I've seen Brooke hanging out with Warren. She seems like his type. American, I hate bully jockstraps like Logan. And he's a Vortex Club member.
What is this Vortex thing? I wish I had. Oh, right, I wanted to see. Where's my photo thing? This will be the weirdest journal entry I will ever make. So weird, I don't know how or where to start, but it started with the most vivid dream. Oh, right. That was how we started the game. I saw this giant tornado was heading towards Arcadia Bay. It was so real that I thought I could feel the rain stinging my face. I was scared shitless. Then a boat hit the lighthouse, and I swear I actually felt like I was going to die. Whoops, sorry. But I woke up in Mr. Jefferson's class, and I wasn't even sleeping. I almost fell out of my chair. Jefferson called on me, but I totally blew the answer, of course. Victoria pounced on me and made me look like a bigger idiot. She's awful. Then I didn't have the guts to turn in a photo for the Everyday Heroes contest while Victoria did her usual suck up to Jefferson. He's so cool and clearly wants me to succeed. Must be nice to have a teacher like that.
It looks like she's been gone for months. Don't be the PC. Missed the Poetry Jam tryouts, and I did not steal that backpack. That's so messed up.
Save Arcadia Bay.
I should contact them to find out what I can do. As if I am. Good thing I left my AK at home.
Oh shit.
There's Hayden, another Vortex Club bro. But he's actually not an ass. Oh, I can hardly wait to never be too cool like Nathan and Victoria. Lame.
What does it mean, though? What does it all mean?
There's Juliet from my dorm. Yet another Vortex Club disciple. God, Samuel is such a weirdo. But I kinda like that about him.
Huh?
Black Wolf sure takes its swimming seriously. But otters are cute. Go, otters.
Otters are cute.
Look at these trophies.
Otters are adorable.
Gotta give it up for those Bigfoots. They do stomp.
If I let the song end. Oh, it's just gonna play the same song over again. Great. How exciting.
the Bigfoot Stomp. I should develop some school spirit. Go team. There's the lighthouse again.
I feel like the lighthouse is going to be a theme. Right, I'm supposed to go to the washroom. To all of you,
American girls, it's sad. Nerd alert. This poster has Warren written all over it. Without you, American girls, I'd empty. Like good. Nobody can see my meltdown. Except for me. Now, who would bother to write that crap?
But is she a bitch, though? That's the real question. I feel like I'm gonna relate to this kid quite a bit. Dope reflections.
The last time I got a flu shot, I got the flu. Fuck you. I'm good to flow. Thanks. This poster must drive people to have sex.
Kate twerks for God.
I remember when somebody punked the alarm last month. At least I got out of science class for that quiz.
I hate Victoria Chase. I swear I didn't write that.
Just relax. Stop torturing yourself. You have a gift. Fuck it.
No! Oh, a butterfly.
When a door closes, a window opens. Or something like that.
Cute.
Okay, girl, you don't get a photo op like this every day.
There's no sneak button. Stop shaking them. Oh, what the fuck?
It's cool, Nathan. Don't stress. You're okay, bro. Just count to three.
Uh-oh.
Don't be scared. You own this school. If I wanted, I could blow it up. You're the boss. So what do you want?
I hope you check the perimeter, as my step-ass would say. Now, let's talk business.
I got nothing for you.
Wrong. You got hella cash.
That's my family, not me.
Oh, boo-hoo, poor little rich kid. I know you've been pumping drugs and shit to kids around here. I bet your respectable family would help me out if I went to them. Man, I can see the headlines now.
Leave them out of this, bitch!
I can tell everybody Nathan Prescott is a punk-ass who begs like a little girl and talks to himself.
You don't know the fuck I am.
Whoa.
Who you're messing around with.
Where'd you get that?
Whoa.
What are you doing? Come on, put that thing down.
Don't ever tell me what to do. I'm so sick of people trying to control me.
You are going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs.
Nobody
hella more trouble.
Even missed your podcast,
hella trouble.
Get that gun away from me, psycho.
Oh. No. Fuck. Wait,
whoa.
What?
What the fuck? How can that be?
Oh, right.
I was in the bathroom. He shot that poor girl. I held up my hand. And then I was back here. He likely was.
These pieces of time. Oh, man.
I already heard this lecture.
From light to shadow. From color.
Now Kate is being hassled again. And if Victoria's phone rings, this is real.
Now, shit! Can you give me an example of a photographer?
I cannot believe this.
Captured the human condition in black and white.
Okay, if I'm crazy,
I might as well go all the way.
Bueller?
Diane.
Can I actually reverse time?
There you go, Victoria. Why Arbus?
Because...
Oh, man. This is cool.
I did it.
Can you give me a photographer who perfectly captured the human condition in black and white? Anybody? Bueller?
Max, don't freak out. Not yet.
There you go, Victoria. Why Arbus?
Because of her
images. Keep it together, Max.
You feel like totally haunted by the eyes of those sad mothers and children.
When I took my selfie, Jefferson asked me a question. If he does again, I'll know this is for real.
Kids call a selfie. A dumb word for a wonderful photographic tradition. And Max has a gift.
I know
a
I'm
gift.
Not dreaming this.
As you all know, the
it's real.
Portrait has been popular
I can tell.
Since the early 1800s. Your generation
so I can go back in time.
Except for I know the answer
selfie
now.
Expression.
What if that girl isn't dead yet?
I couldn't resist. The point
can
remains
I save
that
her?
The portraiture has always been a vital aspect of art and photography for
I need to go to the bathroom quickly and check it out.
Now, Max... Since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits?
I'm sorry. I feel sick. May I be excused?
Nice try, Max. But you're not going to get away that easy. We can talk more after class.
Oh,
is
man.
There anybody
oh,
here
shit.
Who knows their stuff?
Jefferson wants to keep me when after class.
Painter,
and I need time to save that girl.
A process that gave portraits a sharp reflective style like a
mirror. Reverse time.
Now you're totally stuck in the retro zone. Sad face.
Very good, Victoria.
What if I rewind again and give him the right answer?
Okay, there's a little plot point on the spiral thing.
Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits?
The Daguerrean process, invented by a French painter named Louis Daguerre around 1830.
Somebody has been reading as well as posing.
Nailed it.
Nice work, Max.
Fucking
nailed it. The Daguerrean process made portraiture hugely popular. Mainly because it gave the subjects clear, defined features. You can learn more when you actually finish reading the assigned chapters. Max is so far way ahead of everyone. And guys, don't forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday Heroes contest. I'll fly out with the winner to San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the art world. It's great exposure, and it can kickstart a career in photography. So Stella and Alyssa, get it together. Taylor, don't hide. I'm still waiting for your entry, too. And yes, Max, I see you pretending not to see me.
Max, you are not crazy. You are not dreaming. It's time to be an everyday hero.
Can I submit my photo, though?
Victoria, you still have to do your homework this week.
Excuse me, Mr. Jefferson, can I talk to you for a moment?
Yes, excuse you.
No, Victoria, excuse us. I'd never let one of photography's future stars avoid handing in her picture.
I'm not avoiding, just...
Biding time? Waiting for the elusive right moment?
Exactly.
Max, don't wait too long.
Okay.
John Lennon once said that life is what happens while you're busy making other plans. Go on now. Don't let me stop you. Yes, Victoria, you...
Excuse me, Miss...
Photography's future stars avoid handing in her picture.
I'm on top of it. I think John Lennon once said that life is what happens while you're busy making other plans.
Max, you're on fire today. All the right answers, good. Make sure you finish working on it by today. I have faith in you.
A little bit of faith goes a long way. Gotta get to the pooper.
I hope I have enough time to get to the bathroom. Please, please. I can't tell anybody.
Excuse me, Evan.
They'll think I'm crazy.
Na 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 na
na na
Okay, Max, retrace every step. I washed my face. I shredded my photo. Then the butterfly flew in. And I took a photo.
It's the butterfly.
Leave them out of this, bitch!
I can tell everybody Nathan Prescott is a punk ass who begs like a little girl and talks to himself!
You don't know who the fuck I am or who you're messing around with!
Where'd you get that? What are you doing? Come
don't
on, put that thing down!
Tell me what to
do! I need a hammer to break
so
it open!
Sick of people trying to control me!
You are going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs!
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they?
Get that gun away from me, psycho!
Ah, fuck!
Holy shit, I can't let this happen! If I can reverse time again, I can help her.
Control me!
You are going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs!
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they? No way!
Don't ever touch me again, freak!